influenza epidemic after World War I killed 20 million people all by itself. And now we have this new plague, the AIDS epidemic. You know, plagues and epidemics are like a volcano. They're quiet for centuries sometimes, and then they erupt. And we're now in the middle of a volcanic eruption. When it will end, we don't know. When it will quiet down, if it will ever quiet down, we don't know. San Francisco in the mid-70s. It was a time of sexual freedom and gay liberation, mixed with political activism and economic power. The city became the gay capital of the world, but as gays partied into the night, they were unaware that a terrible enemy was already loose in the streets.
In 1974, and I don't know what was the background of it, the city supervisors passed an ordinance that the gay activities are no longer the business of the police. So the police were no longer raiding bars and the back rooms of the bookstores and so on. Now, there were other cities in the country, I can name them, where the gay men were being harassed still by the police. And so when they heard San Francisco is a safe place, they came here.
I had read in an old issue of Life magazine in 1971 that gay people were moving to San Francisco, and I'd heard vague references to homosexuals in San Francisco. So it seemed to me that this was a place of refuge. Living in Phoenix for me was all about hiding. I knew I was gay from a very early age, and I knew that if anyone found out, I would be beaten up and possibly even killed. I mean, it was that way and still is that way in many parts of the country.
The Orange Bowl Parade, Miami's gift to the nation, wholesome entertainment. But in San Francisco, when they take to the streets, it's a parade of homosexuals, men hugging other men, cavorting with little boys, wearing dresses and makeup. The same people who turned San Francisco into a hotbed of homosexuality want to do the same thing to Florida.
Originally, we had, the police reported maybe 30 or 40,000 gay men in the city before 74. By 76, 78, 79, they were saying we have 120,000. It tripled.
We're standing just a few hundred feet away from the corner of Castro and 18th Street, which is the center of the vibrant Castro neighborhood, the center of the gay community in San Francisco. If AIDS was a bomb back in the early 1980s, this was ground zero. This is where the bomb exploded. Certainly the first cases of the epidemic, the first transmissions, all happened literally within a few blocks of this central point. Now, the first most of us heard about it was really in the San Francisco Chronicle, when a reporter back in the 5th of June, 1981, wrote an article talking about a strange new cancer showing up among gay men in San Francisco. At that time, we didn't know what it was, but we were scared to hell by the information that we saw, and people began to wonder if it was contagious, if you could get it from someone else.
When I wrote the first article on AIDS, the first one that I, to my knowledge, appeared anywhere in the country, it was because I saw in the weekly report from the Centers for Disease Control that five cases of a strange type of cancer had been found among gay men in Los Angeles, and I wondered if that wasn't something that was happening here in San Francisco. So I called Dr. Selma Dritz, who was in charge of epidemiology in the San Francisco Health Department, and she said yes. There had been five cases or so here in San Francisco.
That was in June, and by late July, early August, we had our first case reported by a dermatologist in the city of his case of Kaposi sarcoma. Now, we knew that Kaposi sarcoma is a disease of elderly men in the Mediterranean area. And they develop an ulcer with it, and they live 10, 12, 14 years, and they die of something else because it doesn't kill them. But here, this first patient, I won't give his name, of course, but this first patient lasted about 2 months, and he died. And when he was posted, the Kaposi sarcoma, the KS we call it, was not only on his legs, where it's ordinarily found in old men, but it was all over his body internally as well. We could see why it killed him. Yet, why did young, healthy, gay men in San Francisco, who were not elderly, not Mediterranean, develop a disease that doctors here hadn't even heard of for years? 1 week we had 2 cases, the next week we had 4 cases, by the end of the month we had 20 cases, and 2 of them were already dead, or 3 were dead, and it was devastating.